we'd like to slow the pace way, way down and sing a song for you that was from our very first album on Philly International, or otherwise known as CBS Records. And we only hope that you enjoy it half as much as we enjoy singing it for you. It's called If and When.
Was fine.
Was fine.
Need to know. Hello there, Sheila.
Hello there, Ulla.
Nice to have you here.
Thank you. It's nice to be here at last.
Is it?
Yeah.
Yeah. We missed the first time, didn't we?
Yeah, we did.
Unfortunately.
But sometimes those things happen.
Mm-hmm. Hmm? Would you care to tell us a little about the 3 degrees?
Group? The 3 degrees, I imagine, are very new to Norwegian people. Mm. We've been together for about 8 years now, the three of us. And we're trying very hard to be well-liked all around the world by many, many people.
Tell me something about yourself. How did you start out in this business?
I was a solo singer in high school, mm-hmm. scared to death. And my manager was Richard Barrett, and he also managed a group called the 3 Degrees.
Mm-hmm.
And one weekend, one of the girls in the 3 Degrees could not make the engagement. So Richard said, well, that's it, out, you know. So he told me, or asked me, would I fill the spot?
Mm-hmm.
And I filled the spot, and I liked being in a group because I wasn't too particular about being in front of a whole lot of people all by my little self.
Mm-hmm.
So I joined the group, and I stayed because mm-hmm. I liked it.
And then they came in.
Yeah, and then they came in, yeah.
On cue, one might say. So you've been with Fayette and Valerie for 8 years, is that?
Yes, the three of us have been together 8 years.
What did you do for the start, Sheila? No, hang on, I'll get mixed up again. Valerie, sorry.
Sorry. don't strangle him, let him live
later.
A little longer,
okay.
Yes. If he messes it up later, then we'll get it.
Okay.
Yeah. Well, let's see. I was in high school singing also,
mm-hmm.
and after graduation, I decided I wanted to continue in a singing profession, and I was just singing, I guess, until I met the 3 Degrees.
Mm-hmm. Until you met the 3 Degrees?
Yeah.
The other two, that
yeah.
is?
Well, they were always three.
Yeah.
I was sort of like a replacement for someone who wanted to get married, settle down.
And you're not married?
Of course not, are you asking?
What about you, Faye? How did you come into it?
Well, I was in high school also, but I was preparing to go to college, and as I usually do, I run around with lots of groups of kids. I like to go to parties and all those sorts of things, and I joined up with some...
You still like to go to parties, don't you?
Yes, I still like to go to parties. And I joined up with a couple of girls who like to sing,
mm-hmm.
who introduced me to Richard Barrett, and I thought I should have a lot of financial backing for college.
Mm-hmm.
So I decided that I would get into the group and save my money and go to college.
You look nervous. Would you like a cigarette?
Oh, no, thank you. Please, but you have one.
Why not?
Why not? Well, I just don't think it looks very ladylike.
How does a lady look, then?
How does a lady look?
No, it's one of our policies never to smoke on TV for the effect it has on younger children.
Is that so?
Mm-hmm.
Uh-huh. This is the Women's Liberation Year. What do you think about women's liberation?
Right on.
What do you mean, right on?
Well, I think it has had a very decisive effect on the discipline of the male mind.
Mm-hmm.
Because knowing that women are more liberated, men become more introvert.
You've read the book, I understand.
I have read many books, I understand.
Mm-hmm. What about your music, Valerie? Again,
almost.
I'm so concerned about you, that's why.
I understand.
Valerie, what about your music, the three of you?
What about our music?
Yeah. Well, where do you get it from? I mean, your hit records, your hit songs and everything.
Well,
do you dig it up from your mind, or do you compose it yourself?
I wish we had the time. We've often thought of composing songs, but unfortunately with the schedule the way it is, it doesn't allow mm-hmm. time to sit down and relax your mind. So, gamble and huff.
You
said that before.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Gamble and Huff are responsible, along with the other writers of Philadelphia Nashville.
They're probably unknown to us.
Gamble and Huff are the producers uh-huh. of the Philadelphia sound.
I see. The TSOP.
Yes.
How do you like traveling? Touring.
Touring is fantastic. I mean, it's beautiful because you go to so many beautiful places, like Norway.
Mm-hmm.
But the only drag about it is that we're in today, we're filming today, and we're going tomorrow.
Mm-hmm.
And we don't really get a chance to see anything other than looking out of the window of the limousine at the beautiful King's Castle and this, that, and the other. And
isn't that a
beautiful countryside.
Isn't that a pity?
Here. Yes. But we all plan that maybe one day we'll have the fortune of being able to take the time to travel around the world without mm-hmm. singing and to enjoy life a little bit
mm-hmm.
because when other people are going out to see us, we're doing all the work.
Yeah.
You know, and we never get to enjoy ourselves.
Somebody has to have pleasure,
yeah.
right?
And it's our turn, and we're going to get it.
You are, eh?
Yeah.
Are you on again? Or what?
Yes, yeah. We have something to do for it. Would you like to see it?
Yeah, I would love
okay,
it.
Okay, come on, let's do it.
Okay, good.
Okay.
What are you
let you spend it all with me. Let the reasons and the rhymes of your days all begin and end with me. I want to see your face in every kind of light, field of blue and forest of
the world.
It's a lonely place. One look at you, and I know that I can learn to live without the rest.
Tonight, uh-huh. All right. Thank you. Thank you so much. Thank you.
Don't stop. Don't stop. Thank you. You know what? I like those green pants.
I know, I know.
Tell me something. How many of you speak English? Say yeah.
Yeah.
That's fantastic. We can talk for days, huh?
Yeah, I bet you 90% of the people in home speak English, too.
I bet you they do, too.
Hope so.
Because we didn't study Norwegian in school, though.
All I know is ta.
I know something, but I can't say it
talk
on TV. Okay, listen. You know, most of the time, we're traveling around the world so swiftly that we very rarely have time to stop and to think and to say some of the things that we really feel, particularly to people like here in Norway, when we're here one day and we're gone tomorrow. And you can make a lot of friends overnight, I tell you. But what we'd like to say to you and to each of you out there, wherever you go, whatever you do, if our paths never cross again, always remember to take good care of yourself, okay?
Now
Thank you very much. Thank you. You don't know how happy you made us tonight. Thank you. Yes. Thank you. And thank you. Thank you. You want more? A lot more? I'd like to, this is going to be very difficult. I've got to change your mood completely from dirty old man and dirty old ladies, we can't leave out the dirty old ladies, into a personal story that once happened. You know, it's a very, very, for most people, it's a very, very beautiful thing when you fall in love. Because instantly you feel as though you're a special person. Because you feel nobody in the whole wide world could ever possibly be as happy as you are at that time in your life. But the painful thing is that most often, that beautiful, beautiful feeling turns into something very painful. And then you begin to discover the agonies that true love can bring. Because you see, that's when the need is greater than the want. And there's nothing you can do about it. I remember standing in an airport with someone who was very, very dear to me. And in those last few minutes when neither one of us knew what to say, I looked into his eyes, searching and hoping and wondering. And I remember thinking to myself, dear God, when will I see you again?